Well, what's up guys, this is Daniel from Arms Family Homestead, and I have to admit, I fell off the wagon. I'm actually just drinking coffee, and I'm not talking about falling off that wagon. But you remember that fencing project we were working on? Yeah, that one, still not complete. Actually, have made very little progress in the last 2 weeks. It's just been one of those things with the holidays, the weather. Look, see the weather? It's been rainy and dreary. It's kind of hard to build a fence in the rain. And it's just kind of, been like every time my days off come around, it was raining. So hopefully we're gonna get a little work done on the fence after I finish my coffee this morning. Gotta go wake my brother up. I'm sure he's still asleep. I'm gonna have him come help me. But today, my goal anyways, is to get out here and get all of our corner post and stretch post set in concrete. I have to let those set for 2 or 3 days before we can do anything there. A lot of people had questions in the last video when we were talking about building a fence. We are not gonna dig a hole for every post all the way down. So what I'm doing is setting corner posts. We'll set those in pipe and then concrete them in the ground. We'll have a gate up here, and then it'll just be T-post drove in the ground down along the fence. So we're not building like a wooden post fence with every fence post being in wood. There'll be metal T-posts, but we got to get those corner posts set and get those set really deep in concrete so that we can pull our fence tight. We don't want to pull our post over. So anyways, I'm gonna finish my coffee, go wake my brother up, and hopefully we'll get some fence building done today. Helpers won't quit complaining about it being cold. Both of them, my hands are cold, my ears are cold. It's not that cold, it's like 35 degrees out here. It's not raining, it's not snowing, and we're getting work done. Getting concrete set, or getting posts set in concrete. Yeah, they're a little tall right now, but we'll cut them off, clean them up. It's just scrap pipe we had laying around here, so gotta use it up.
North, about three pipe.
Well, north is that way.
Oh yeah, whatever direction that is.
Told you these guys were complaining because it was cold. They are building a fire with all the empty concrete sacks. They're freezing. Not standing very close to that fire.
I'd say send my girlfriend back.
Oh yeah? What'd you say?
Ooh, I love you. Mwah,
mwah. You sent heart kissy emojis, didn't you?
Yeah.
That's how you know when you don't pay your help well enough. They quit working. One's walking off that way. One's sitting over here building a fire with feed sacks or concrete sacks. I guess I'm gonna have to up their pay to more coffee and cereal or something. I'm not sure.
So we made some pretty good progress today. Got most of our corner posts and stretch posts and gate hanging posts, whatever you want to call those, all set in concrete. Now, I know there's about a million different ways to do all of this stuff. You can use wood, you can use pipe. I prefer steel pipe, mostly because, well, two reasons. I have the steel pipe laying here as leftover pipe from projects in the past. And second, pipe will always outlast wood. A lot of people use wood corner posts and they work just fine, but they're only gonna last so many years before they rot. Now, the way we do our fence post, our corner post and stretch post, we don't pre-mix the concrete. I just buy concrete in a bag. It's a ready mix style concrete. It doesn't require to be mixed with sand or gravel or anything. It's already got it in the bag, and it's about just under $4 a bag, and we're putting about two bags of concrete per hole. Some of them are taking three because we dug such big holes. But I don't pre-mix the concrete. I know a lot of people are gonna say, oh my God, how's your concrete gonna set up? Well, it just does. It just does. We pour a little bit of water in the bottom of the hole before we start, and then pour water on top, kind of mix it in a little bit. I promise you, it absorbs so much moisture out of the ground. Here, lately, it's been raining like crazy. The ground, as you could tell as we're digging and all the mud on our boots, the ground is saturated with water. I promise you, that concrete will set up hard as a rock. It doesn't have to be mixed first. We've built a lot of fence in my lifetime. Before my dad passed away, which was 2005, he was a fence builder. He worked for the National Park Service in summertime, but in the wintertime, he built fence for a living. He had a fence building company. My brother and I built a lot of fence over the years, and we've put hundreds of pipe in the ground, just dumping bags of concrete in the hole, pouring a little water and mixing it in there. It will set up hard as a rock, I promise. So we're, like I said earlier, we're not gonna be putting post in it. Well, we're not gonna be digging a hole and setting post for every post along the fence. We're just gonna use T-posts. We'll drive those down in the ground. We're gonna be using, I'm not sure yet, some sort of sheep and goat wire or maybe horse wire. I haven't priced all of the wire yet. I haven't decided what I'm gonna use, but I wanna use something good, really strong, something that'll stay really tight, because we will be rotating our buck through this pasture here, little paddock, whatever you want to call it, small area, and it takes a really strong fence to keep him separated from the does, no matter if whether it's the buck I've got now or a different buck down the line. But anyway, so we've got kind of, let me go over here, show you what we got. So this is a corner post here. It'll have an H brace to that post there, and then we'll have a down drop, one that goes down to that short pipe, which we'll actually end up cutting that one shorter, and that'll hold this fence nice and tight. We'll have the same thing on the other end and a walk-through gate off the corner of the barn. This corner will be here. I'm gonna put a gate big enough that I can drive my tractor through here, as you can see, from that corner post over to there. So I have about a 12-foot gate, an H brace, a couple pipe across that to help support that gate, and then an H on that corner, another down drop, shooting down to the other fence that is what's holding the goats in their pasture down there now. Do the same thing there, back to the barn, and we'll have a three-sided fence, basically. Use the barn as one wall for them to hold them in. So it'll work out pretty good. As I said in the previous video when we were talking about building this fence, it may be close to an acre, probably gonna be closer to half an acre. So it's not really a big area, but it will give us another place to have to separate animals out. We are still in the works of getting a new animal here on the farm, or animals. Not gonna let you know just yet. That is still in the works, but we're actually probably gonna get them before this fence is done. I'll have to keep them down there in the corral. It'll work. But anyways, we're gonna have to wait a couple days to let all of our posts set up, our concrete set up. It's gotta cure for probably at least 48, maybe 72 hours, so 2-3 days, which it'll have all weekend. And then we can come in and start welding our cross braces in on our corner posts and our gate posts and stuff like that. So it'll be at least a week before we're able to stretch wire before we're even ready to stretch the wire, and the concrete will be more than set up. So anyways, I'm gonna quit rambling. Guys, that's all I've got for today. More work on the fence. Here, we're down here by the barn now. So as you can see, this will be an H brace, and we've kind of got a weird funky angle. So I just put in another post there. We'll weld pipe to that. The fence will tie off on that middle post, and then we'll have a walkthrough gate here next to the barn. So it'll be cool. Guys, that's all I've got for today. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Y'all have a great day. And as always, we'll see you on the next video.